Good morning and welcome here to day three of the 2016 Division I WFTDA playoffs live from Saint-Pierre Chabanneau here in Montreal, Quebec, Canada. I'm Mr. Whistler.
I'm Pink Lemonade. It is a good morning here in Montreal, but it's also a good evening in Helsinki, where it's 5 p.m. local time. Of course, they'll be cheering for Kallio Rolling Rainbow coming up in our ninth place game. Midnight in Brisbane, Australia, home of the Sun State Swarm. That's going to be playing for ninth place just behind us. That's our first game of the morning. Sun State, a narrow loss from Boston. Probably our most dramatic finish of the weekend yesterday. 172-171, won in the final jam by Boston. So they're going to be just itching for a win here. Kallio, their first time at playoffs. No wins yet this weekend, but winning a lot of fans over here in Montreal.
Oh yeah, both teams have been really dynamic, and they're hungry. Like we saw, Kallio has posted on social media. They are hungry. They're looking for this win. This is not about food. They're looking
Although
for that win.
Although the food is great here.
The food is great here as well. What comes up then for the seventh place game?
So for seventh place at noon is going to be the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls versus the Detroit All Stars. Either way, they move up in their seeding. Rocky's at 10, Detroit's at 9. They're playing for seventh place. Both with a long derby pedigree. Long history with the WFTDA, and both on a bit of a downswing rankings-wise. So this will be a nice boost for them at the end of the weekend. Either way, they go home better seated than they came in, but a seventh-place win would be really important.
Yeah, and that's going to be a very physical game. We've seen a lot of physicality from both of those teams this weekend, so you're not going to want to miss that one. The fifth-place game comes up at 2 p.m.
Yep. That's Boston v. Dallas. And, of course, Boston, the story of that team this weekend is those two narrow, nail-biting wins they just came off of. And the home crowd, especially in the southeastern Canada, northeastern U.S., like a lot of fans in the crowd for Boston, so that's going to be an exciting game.
Yeah, a lot of them made the trip, so this is going to be very loud here in venue. Speaking of loud in venue, the home team going for third place, possibly able to punch a ticket for champs. We'll have to see.
Yeah, Montreal has a long history of just narrowly missing a ticket to championships. And here on their home turf for the first Canadian Division I playoff, it is going to be bonkers in here. Absolutely bonkers. Bay Area sort of having to play the bad guy. They've been to championships 4 years running. It would be a devastating loss for them to not make it this year.
Yeah, and just to quickly wrap up, of course, we have a gold medal game. Two teams who have already punched their ticket to champs, but looking for seeding privileges, London versus Texas.
Yeah, we don't always see a lot of shakeup in those top 6 to 10 teams. London's at 3 and Texas is at 5, but Texas has a deep jammer rotation here this weekend. London, meanwhile, his Stephanie Maney is a perennial favorite. Master Blaster just transferred from Berlin, so they're a bit of a question.
And tournament leading scorer thus far for London, actually, is Andracula with 186 points. 88% lead percentage, Rogue Runner up there at 185. Then we have Rookard from Detroit, 185. Master Blaster, as you mentioned, 180 points. Space Invader and Freight Train from Boston and Texas, respectively, at 178.
Well, it's going to be an exciting day of roller derby. It's been an exciting weekend so far. You know, story of the weekend is like a lot of the lower level upsets, you know, and then at the top level, maybe we can see an upset in that gold medal game.
Well,
you
Texas and London is going to be one for the history books, as will the rest of the day. We've got five games ahead of us coming up here on WFTDA TV. I'm Mr. Whistler.
I'm Pink Slaminade.
This is Pink Slaminade. And we're going to be throwing it up to Lightning Slim and Captain Lou up in the booth.
Thank you, Mr. Whistler. Thank you, Pink Slaminade. I am Lightning Slim. I'm joined here by my good friend, Captain Lou Albamo. You are, as they mentioned, watching the 2016 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs live from beautiful Montreal, Canada, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and Montreal Roller Derby. So, our first matchup of the day, we'll be seeing Kallio taking on Sun State. Kallio from Helsinki, Finland, coming into the tournament as the number 7 seed, currently ranked 27th in the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. Sun State coming from Browns Plains in Queensland, Australia. entering the playoffs, number 8, ranked 29th in the WFTDA. Captain Lou, shall we start with a roster?
Straight into the roster. Sun State Swarm going to send to their bench today the skaters they brought with them. 00 Coconuts, 117 Chop Chop, more on her later. 180 SX, 182 Sticks and Bones, 187 Veruca Assault, 24 Trauma Junkie, 32 Jambi, 58 Dodge and Bolt, 65 Janosaurus Rex, 7 Baby Rocket, 89 Slayer Swift, and number 90 Edwards.
And for Kallio's Rolling Rainbow, their all-star team called the Kallio All Colors, number 10 Layla Gay, 103 Bella Glucosi, number 13 Mischief, 13, 14, Picante, number 19, Kutti Schrodinger, number 21, Schlagerloff, 333, Valhalla, number 410, Vatuvima, 4444, Do Me Behind, number 49, Macho Bichu, 60, KO, number 72, Pretty Sick, 777, Sarah Gilbert, and number 9, Teabag.
Yeah, just the brief information on the Sun State bench. Chop Chop, injured in that first game against Detroit, had actually hurt her calf, a little calf tear, about 4 weeks before coming to this tournament. Had done some rehab. Our physio said that she was able to play, but if she tore the calf again, just to get back on crutches and they'd fix it when she got back to Australia. That's what happened in the game against Detroit, and that's why she's not going to be playing today, Slim.
Yeah, I saw Chop Chop after that first game, and she had immediately placed ice on the leg and got herself back onto the crutches. So hopefully that does not trouble her for too much longer.
So yeah, I mean, Kallio versus Sun State, the 7 seed versus the 8 seed, playing for 9th or 10th in this tournament. As mentioned by Mr. Whistler, both teams quite hungry for a win at this tournament. They've both lost, Kallio losing to Rocky Mountain, 155-151, a heartbreaking loss for the Finns.
And then, so close.
And then getting knocked down by Dallas, 181-81. Sun State came close against Detroit on day one, 204-180. And then another heartbreaking loss, that was to Boston, 172-171. So both these teams have similar paths getting to this game, both involving jams in the last seconds of the game, resulting in losses.
Yeah, an exciting finish for the crowd, but heartbreak for one of the two teams. And of course, coming in as the 7th and 8th seeds into the tournament, this is the 9-10 game. Captain Lou, nobody wants to go out last.
No one wants to go out last. Sun State finishing 8th in the Division I playoff in Dallas last year. First appearance for Kallio. And, yeah, I mean, they're excited to get going in this game. We should go with some officials.
Yeah, our officials for this contest. Crew head referee, umpire strikes back. He'll be joined by Izzy Demented, Freddie Mercury Poisoning, Fluke Skywalker, Jean-Philippe Amann, Kurt Sogood, and Parking Lot, our alternate referee, Judge Double Wapner.
Kallio, of course, ending last year, or at least the last regular season for playoffs, ranked 101st in the WFTDA, played a very targeted schedule over the course of the year to get themselves into this 27th place. We'll see if they can pull off a victory against the Australians. Australians not wanting to go home without a win themselves. Sarah Gilbert's going to be the first person to take the star for the Rolling Rainbow, and it is going to be Jambi for the Swarm.
Interesting to see both of these overseas teams playing on sport court. They've had some difficulty with it in the early going of the tournament. We'll see if some adjustments have been made as play gets underway. Wow. And right away, a penalty to Gilbert. She will sit for Rolling Rainbow. That means Jambi on the power jam for Sun State.
This is exactly how Kallio has started their two previous games. First jam into the game, take a jammer penalty. Australia's getting a chance to have a power jam.
Yep, lead for Jambi now, cautiously approaching a pack. Signals her blockers who move in for the sweep. Jambi. A nice maneuver there executed by Sun State. That is the full 5 points.
Jambi, 160 points in this tournament, 73 in her game against Detroit, 87 against Boston.
Jambi looking again, getting a half sweep this time as some of her blockers break away to go in and hold back Gilbert at the rear of the pack. Now Jambi skating through the infield as she's recycling herself. We are now in turn number 3. The pack split into two halves. Sun State making some choices between offense and defense. Jambi breaks free again.
The star pass to Machu Bichu. She'll be the jammer of record now and force that call off. So then we'll see if any additional points. No, of course not. They're already out of the zone of engagement, but two full scoring passes by the Sun State Swarm jammer. Jambi puts 10 points on the scoreboard, 10-0 in the first jam of this game. Rydell Skates, innovative leader in the roller skating industry for over 70 years, rydellskates.com. Yeah, Kallio continuing to have jammer penalty problems. We'll probably talk about that more during this game. We'll see what happens in jam number two. They're putting Picante out there for the all colors. It's Baby Rocket for the Swarm.
Baby Rocket making an early play to the front of the pack. Has a braced four to deal with there, as does Picante in the back. The jammers in separate solitudes. No lead jammer yet declared as they continue to push. Baby Rocket tries the inside line, manages to knock down one of the Kallio blockers, holding the face there. Baby Rocket recycled. Picante, troubles of her own. A direction of gameplay penalty will take one blocker off the track.
That's teabag for Kallio.
Teabag did manage to shake Picante loose, though, and she has lead.
Yeah, Picante, the lowest scorer for the All Colors, 33, but has not taken a penalty in this tournament. That's super valuable for the All Colors.
A completed scoring pass there for Picante, 4 points. Baby Rocket approaches the pack. That will force the call off.
That'll keep it at a 4-0 jam, but Kallio on the scoreboard nice and early on this early morning game of the final day of the D1 in Montreal. Again, it is for placing 9th or 10th place. The Kallio All Colors jammer rotation has taken 10 jammer penalties per game. A lot of them are happening in the beginning of the game. Pretty Sick is on the line for the All Colors. It's going to be Trauma Junkie for Swarm.
Trauma Junkie, who has been known to leap into the center of defensive formations, now heads to the front, gets a little bit of support from her blocker, Sticks and Bones. Pretty Sick, taken into turn number one, held at the line. Trauma Junkie jumps out for lead. No pass. A no pass, so she is out, not lead.
Pretty Sick still could get lead, but scoring is happening already.
Yeah, now Trauma Junkie inside the pack on a scoring pass. And yes, Pretty Sick does achieve lead, does what she needs to do immediately, calls off the jam.
See how many points were scored. It's one of those situations if the other jammer gets out first and then gets all the way around the track. Yes, 3 points picked up by Trauma Junkie. Sometimes at that point, you might as well go for that scoring pass anyways, because you're giving up a 3-0 jam, even though you got that lead jammer status. But they haven't been in the pack yet, sure, call it off. But if the points are being scored already, you go get your points yourself. 13-4 is the score. Sun State ahead of Kallio. 25 minutes, 40 seconds remaining in the first half. Leila Gay taking the start for the All Colors. That's Jambi for the Swarm.
Jambi carefully picking her way up the inside line. Runs into Teabag as she switches to the out. Leila Gay trying to push, challenging the links of Sun State, trying to get inside that defensive formation. That's a three. Now broken apart, Leila Gay water skiing behind a blocker. Still cannot find the exit out of the pack, neither jammer. Jambi now pushing. The pack moves together through the back straightaway, and it is Jambi who emerges first for lead.
Second lead jammer status for Jambi and Sun State.
Leila Gay removes the star. Will she stash or pass? Meanwhile, Jambi cruising quite slowly, yes, between turns 3 and 4, the pack was just drifting, and Jambi now picking up speed, comes out with 5.
Yeah, continuing to show why she's the top scorer for Sun State in this tournament.
Leila Gay had stashed the star, now emerges from the pack, puts it back on her head. Jambi gets into the pack, inverts, tries to get the hips in for that extra point. Doesn't manage to do so. No change to score on that final pass as the jam is called. Captain Lou.
Yeah, Sun State still wins that jam 5-0, 18-4 on the scoreboard. 24 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the first half of this game. 888 helmets, pads, wrist guards, we've got you covered. 888.com. Sarah Gilbert going to take the star again for Kallio. She is their top jammer. She has 82 points in this tournament, but she has picked up 10 penalties over the course of the tournament. 6 in the first game, 4 in the second game, 1 in this game, needs to stay out of the box.
She took that penalty right off the hop at the first whistle of the game, but skating cleanly now. So Gilbert with 2 blockers to beat at the front of the pack as Baby Rocket recycled Gilbert for lead.
And we've seen that Sarah Gilbert is able to get out of the pack first. It's just that penalty control she needs to keep.
Oh, Gilbert upended, taking a blocker down with her at the apex. Does not receive the penalty. That going to the blocker. Blocker for each side going to the penalty area. Low blocking the call. Gilbert with the full five on the scoring pass. Star pass happening here for Sun State. Dodge and Bolt now wearing the star for the Swarm. Call off happening there.
So that's what the all colors need from Sarah Gilbert. They're top jammer on this team. 13 points for Kallio so far in this game. 9 points scored by Sarah Gilbert in that jam. 18, Sun State remains at 22 minutes, 50 seconds remaining in the first half of this game. Fast Girl Skates is proud to sponsor the 2016 WFDA Tournament MVPs. You will, of course, be able to find out who wins that MVP award if you watch the championship game and stay tuned to the ceremony afterwards.
Picante and Trauma Junkie, jammers of the right now. Picante running up against Edwards. Trauma Junkie spinning around now with two blocks to beat, hip to hip with Schlagerloff. A one-on-one battle with Schlagerloff and Trauma Junkie. Trauma Junkie finally splits the defenders, steps through, gains lead.
Direction of gameplay on Schlagerloff, Slim.
Schlagerloff was working hard on that play. Picante also through. Completes that initial pass, but scoring happening. From Trauma Junkie, who calls it off.
Take all 5 points, got the jammer lap point as well. 23 points for Sun State, 13 for Kallio. Again, 21 minutes, 40 seconds remaining in the first half. Teams dueling back and forth. Lead jammer status trading with great regularity. Three per side. It's kind of what we expect when you have teams ranked so closely. Again, 29th overall for Sun State, 27th for Kallio. So you expect it to be a close game. We're getting that early on so far, Slim.
Pretty sick. And Jambi with great speed pulls into that lead position. Pretty sick battling at the back of the pack. The pack still inside the starting area. Pretty sick tries to step around the outside. Her opponent falls. A no pass given there. So Pretty sick can continue. Jambi recycled, taken back there. Now Jambi on a scoring pass up against two. Splits that defense quite neatly. Jambi with the call off.
Jambi 3 for 3 in this game. We're getting lead jammer status. Check 4 more points put up on the board. 27-13 the score. Jambi with 19 of those 27 points. Once again, putting the majority of the points on the scoreboard. We're going to get ourselves an official review being called.
Yeah, that's charged to Sun State.
And of course, this official review is sponsored by RollerGirl.ca, Canada's skate shop. Experience Canada's or Canadian customer service. I suppose it's kind of the same thing.
Sure.
Canada customer service, Canadian customer service, it's all the same.
It's good service.
Yeah, trust us. We experience it daily. So, yeah, an official review being called. It is being called by Sun State. So early on in the half to be calling it, 20 minutes and 40 seconds is where the clock has been sealed. Sun State has built themselves to a 14-point lead over Kallio. We'll see if we can get some clarification on that as things proceed. But, yeah, I mean, both these teams have traveled a long way to play this game, Slim. It's kind of one of the fun things about the division level playoffs is because they are international.
That's right.
You get the international flavor, and the odds of a team from Finland and a team from Australia getting to play each other during the regular season, probably not high.
No, I would not suspect so. And so it's great to have them be able to experience each other's gameplay here in Montréal.
And for most of the WFTDA.TV viewers, likely the first time they have had a chance to see Kallio, the other team out of Helsinki, Finland. They start a little after the Helsinki team, which you'll see later in the Division I playoffs. But great to see a second Finnish team playing at the division level.
So the clock frozen at 20:40 in the first period of play. Very interested to see what the nature of the official review will be. We'll get you that information as soon as possible. Sun State, a score of 27 and Kallio 13.
So yeah, penalties over the course of this weekend. 31.5 per game for Kallio, 10 jammer penalties, 36 for Sun State, 8.5 jammer penalties. So little advantage in the jammer side, but also a little disadvantage in the blocker side. So.
All right, we've just received word that Sun State was asking for a cutting the track call on Kallio's jammer in the previous jam. That cut was not awarded, so no change to gameplay, loss of official review, and there is Baby Rocket, number 7 for the Swarm, in lead. They didn't get their review, but they did get lead in this jam.
Review is gone for the half, but they're leading in. They've got lead. Five lead jammer statuses so far, Slim, out of 8.
Oh, multi-body pileup just outside turn number 1. A high block penalty coming there to Schlagerloff.
And a low block penalty coming to Baby Rocket.
Yeah, problematic as the jammer for Sun State will head to the penalty area. Power jam there for Layla Gay of Kallio.
So there you go, one jammer penalty per side in this game. The power jams will even up. We'll see what Layla Gay can do with this, though, Slim.
Layla Gay continuing to push the pack. Frozen now in the back straightaway. Now Kallio playing some offense, trying to create some space for Layla Gay.
Layla Gay, 34 points in her first game against Rocky Mountain, only 4 against Dallas, 38 on the weekend.
Stretching out that pack, Layla Gay now turns a duo into a single, but is recycled.
Sun State losing their pivot to the penalty box. That's SX.
Reinforcements from the penalty area for Kallio at Schlagerloff, and Baby Rocket also at liberty, approaching the pack. This is a good penalty kill for Sun State as Layla Gay still held. And overtaken now as Baby Rocket comes out for a 5-point pass.
Finally, Layla Gay getting through on her first pass, Slim.
Yeah, 5 points for Kallio also, but Baby Rocket ahead. This jam only a few seconds remaining as both jammers get stuck into the pack again. The whistles blow. We'll see where it shakes out on the scoreboard. Captain Lou.
One additional point for Sun State, but Layla Gay getting more of her hips past blockers for Kallio. 3 additional points for her. 8-6 in the jam. Kallio does win it, but remember, it was a power jam for Kallio. So only 2 additional points scored by the All Colors. 33-21 is the score. 18 minutes, 18 seconds remaining in the first half. And on the fast girl start line, Sarah Gilbert, number 777 for the All Colors, going up against Trauma Junkie.
Gilbert tries to barge through the center of the pack. Sarah Gilbert with force, lead jammer for the All Colors.
And once again, you see Sarah Gilbert, as long as she skates it clean, is going to be able to put points on the board for the All Colors.
Trauma Junkie still inside the pack. Gilbert now in a scoring pass, getting the sharp end of a triangle of blockers. Switches directions, and Gilbert inverts and calls off the jam with 3 points on the board.
Kallio now at 24, trailing the 33 of Sun State by 9. 17.5 minutes remaining in the first half. Sarah Gilbert with 12 points for her team. Exactly half of the points scored in this game by the All Colors. WFTDA would like to thank Derby Central, RollerCon, and S1. Thank you. On the fast girl start line, Picante for the All Colors and Jambi for Sun State.
Sun State taking the rear of the start position. That will hold Picante. Jambi knocking down the blocker who was trying to hold her on the inside line. No pass there, however. Jambi does not have lead but is in front. Picante gains lead. And calls before Jambi can hit the pack.
No.
Just 2 points. A burst of speed there from Jambi to come in quickly and gain those 2 points.
Yeah, so that's the second time that Kallio has done that. They have not gotten, Sun State does not get lead. They get out of the pack, try to call things off, and 2 points scored.
And a word there from Kallio to the jammer referees, the coach not happy with the speed of the whistle on
for
that
sure.
Play.
Yeah, it was a touch late. And
Baby Rocket, pretty sick. Jammers of the now. Baby Rocket knocked to her knees, pretty sick with a nice move around the outside. Lead.
Second lead jammer of the game for pretty sick. Direction of gameplay on KO.
pretty sick. Now in a scoring pass, trying to move around the outside star pass happening here for Sun State. Dodge and Bolt took the star for Sun State, was unable to engage with the pack before the jam was called off. 3 points on the board for Kallio.
So Kallio now within 8 of Sun State, 35-27 to score, 15 minutes, 30 seconds remaining in the first half. And Adam Skates just got a lot more colorful. AdamSkates.com is where you can find out how colorful they are.
Colorful, like the all colors.
That's very appropriate. Layla Gay jamming for the all colors. Trauma Junkie for the Swarm.
Trauma Junkie dynamically trying to move in inside that triangle of blockers. Now gets some support. Still no lead jammer yet declared as Trauma Junkie got recycled. Layla Gay held by a trio of blockers in between turns 1 and 2. Trauma Junkie held at turn number 1. Both jammers in their own private perditions. Pushing. Now we move into the back straightaway. Still working away. These jammers trying to move into that lead position, or at least just find their way out of the pack. Penalty to Kallio. It is teabag number 9. Star Stash there.
Interesting.
Layla Gay makes it out.
Yeah, Star Stash without anyone having gotten out of the pack yet there.
Yeah, lead was still up for grabs.
Well, it's not for her anymore.
But on a scoring pass, Layla Gay sure. Inside the pack. The pack frozen at turn 3. Star pass for Sun State.
So we'll go the full distance.
Yeah, no lead now. SX putting on the star for the Swarm. Layla Gay comes out with 5. SX barging through the pack. 4 for SX of Sun State.
And sometimes those star passes can be risky to a pivot that's not used to jamming, but SX getting it done.
Yeah, SX looking pretty comfortable doing that. Layla Gay completing another pass. That's an additional 4 points for the all colors. Back. Now inside the pack again. Layla Gay, oh, just finds a neat bit of room on the inside line in turn number 1. She cuts through there and picks up 4 more.
Briefly on the scoreboard, Kallio had a lead. I believe there's 4 additional points being added to the Sun State side, though. So it's a 13-8 jam as we go with a full 2 minutes. A star stash and a star pass resulting in no lead jammer. 3-point lead for Sun State, 43-40, just under 13 minutes remaining in the first half of this game. And with no Sun State skaters on the track, I suspect we'll get ourselves a timeout. I always like it when that's done by coaches.
Indeed, not lining up at all and simply waiting for the opportunity.
Yeah. And, of course, this team timeout is sponsored by RollerGirl.ca, Canada's skate shop experience, the Canadian dollar. Yeah, I like it when you keep your team off to the sideline, maximize those 30 seconds. Jen Heath going in there and chatting with umpire strikes back during the timeout while the bench coach also manages the team. But, yeah, you just get that extra 29 seconds of talking time to your team, and you get to sow a little confusion among the fans and your opponents when nobody's on the track. It's like, oh, my God, the jam's going to start. No. Totally under control.
So the teams, as you mentioned earlier, Captain Luke, closely ranked and closely contesting.
It is. I mean, a 3-point game. It's exactly how you want to start off day 3, isn't it? So, yeah, clock stopped at 12 minutes and 38 seconds. Looking at the lead jammer status is 6 on the Kallio side, 4 for Sun State. So even though Sun State has not had lead jammer quite as much as Kallio, they still have managed to pick up the lead courtesy of their very successful power jam that they had. Power jam not as successful for Kallio. 1 jammer penalty aside in this game. Penalties still fairly slim so far. 6 over on the Sun State side and 10 for Kallio. We'll get Derby underway.
Sarah Gilbert and Jambi. Sarah Gilbert leaping into that lead position. Jambi trying to give chase. Now breaks out from the pack. Things picking up speed here as Gilbert approaches the back of the pack. Kallio trying to grab a goat. A quick call off.
Rick Koloff looking for points from the jammer. If Gilbert in her first game against Rocky Mountain took six penalties but still managed to get 58% lead jammer status in that game. She got out of the pack a lot first, but picked up a lot of penalties in doing so. No points scored in that jam, but the lead jammer status does mean that they were able to control when the jam came to its conclusion. 43-40 is the score. 12 minutes remaining in the first half. Picante going up against Baby Rocket.
Baby Rocket tries the outside route. She's shoulder to shoulder with Picante. Now Baby Rocket breaks off into the front formation. Is able to squeeze through that defensive posture of Kallio. Baby Rocket lead for Sun State. Picante also escaping the pack. Baby Rocket approaches, runs into one blocker, knocked down there.
Good defensive effort by Teabag at the back. Gets the hip on Baby Rocket, forces her out of bound. She can't get back onto the track in time to get a call off. No points given up in that jam. It's another scoreless jam, 40-43. Kallio trailing by three, Sun State in the lead. 11 minutes, 15 seconds remaining in the first half. Pretty Sick gonna take the star for the All Colors, and that's Trauma Junkie for Sun State.
Yeah, no high-flying multi-point jams, really. Just good hard grind in the pack. Trauma Junkie getting into the center of things. She seems to like doing that quite a bit. Oh, now many bodies bowled over even before we've hit turn number one. Trauma Junkie recycled. Sticks and Bones grabs Trauma Junkie's jersey and spins her around. I'm not sure that play quite worked out the way it was supposed to. It was Pretty Sick moves into lead.
75% lead jammer status for Pretty Sick as well.
In that pileup, Sticks and Bones receiving a penalty. Pretty Sick completing a five-point pass. And yeah, we have a lead change as Pretty Sick making a cautious but very effective apex jump.
Pretty Sick with three penalties in the first game, five in the second game, not wanting to take any more for her team.
Still on a scoring pass, Pretty Sick going into the pack. Star pass on the Sun State side. They've resorted to doing this quite a bit. Dodge and Bolt has been the recipient of some of those stars. She takes it again, but the jam called off with three more points on the board for Kallio.
Yeah, I mean, Sun State over the regular season would average about two star passes per game. Well past that in this game already, using it to keep the score under control. They've had the lead up to this point, but 13 points put up by Pretty Sick means Kallio now is the superior on the scoreboard. 53-43, Kallio over Sun State. Next jam underway with Sarah Gilbert up against Jambi. And Sarah Gilbert through quickly.
As is Jambi. Sarah Gilbert has a look over her shoulder, sees Jambi coming, and we have ourselves a race. The pack responding to the race also, moving quickly, and the call-off forced smiles from both jammers.
Yeah, Sarah Gilbert just spun around at the end and realized Jambi was literally right behind her. Nobody falling to the ground, though, but another scoreless jam in this game. Four scoreless jams in a row for Sun State. They've been held at 43. Kallio still at 53, under 9 minutes remaining in the first half of this game. Picante getting the star on her helmet for Kallio, and it's going to be Baby Rocket for Sun State on the Fast Girl start line.
We've seen these two jammers paired up before.
Sticks and Bones right back to the penalty box, Slim.
Yeah, she's a mainstay in the Sun State defense. It's not good for her to gain that many penalties in the first half. Picante bursting out of the pack for lead, but Baby Rocket gives chase. Pack slowed down, sitting in two. Now, Kallio moving forward, picking up the speed of things. Picante reaches them, calls it off. We'll see.
Did she get a hip around? Slayer Swift was at the back of the pack. She really wants her single point. We'll have to wait for the discussion to come through. And yes, the answer is no, she's going to take two because Sticks is in the penalty box. So one will get you two with the hips. And that was just at the last second, went inverted, put a hip check on Slayer Swift, knocked her to the ground and grabbed her point. 2-0 in that jam. Kallio now 55, Sun State 43. Jammers will be Layla Gay and Jambi.
Jambi was the first into the center of the pack, now running into the defenses of Kallio. Sticks and Bones busts that apart. That's what Sticks and Bones does best. And now Jambi has lead.
Sticks and Bones picks up another penalty in doing so, though.
Layla Gay fighting in turn number two. Two blockers to beat. She tries to split the defense. No pack. They release Layla Gay. Meanwhile, Jambi inside the pack, scoring up against Teabag and Dumi behind. Jam comes to a close with 3 points on the board for Sun State.
All right, so 55-46. Kallio still in the lead. 9 points separate the team. 6 minutes, 50 seconds remaining in the half. Penalties again, fairly slim on both sides. Only 9 penalties for Sun State, 11 penalties for Kallio. However, Callio's skater, number 444, did get enough fours in there. Anyway, four fours. Dumi behind has 4 trips to the penalty box, 3 trips for Sticks and Bones, both of those skaters are mainstays in their offense and defense. So
pretty sick and Trauma Junkie off the Fast Girl start line. Trauma Junkie first to emerge from the pack, does a bit of a dance with the pivot of Kallio, but now skating in the free and open spaces. Pretty sick moves to the front also. Pretty sick coming out of the pack, but Trauma Junkie on a scoring pass, calling it off, looking at her jammer referee. A little bit of a conversation there from Trauma Junkie, but she has 4 points and the jam is over. Captain Lou.
5 points now separate the teams, 55-50, as the score remains in Callio's favor. 5 minutes, 50 seconds remaining in this half. Trauma Junkie, the most consistent jammer for Sun State over the course of this tournament. 48 points against Detroit, 48 points against Boston, 48 points per game. 58% lead jammer against Detroit, 59% against Boston.
Pack advantage, Sun State. Bella Glucosi in the penalty area. Sarah Gilbert jamming for Kallio. It is Baby Rocket for Sun State. These jamming patterns seem to repeat themselves, Captain Lou.
They do.
Sarah Gilbert for lead.
Well, Kallio running a 4 jammer rotation, Sun State running a 3, so we're getting the matchups rotating through.
Gilbert now on a scoring pass, tries to get into the center of a triangle. Billy Gucosi coming back from the penalty area.
11th lead jammer status for Kallio in this half, 20 jams in.
Gilbert for 5. Coming into the pack, skating smoothly. Interpack hitting. A little bit of swinging around here. Some retaliatory strikes. A star pass. SX once again holding the star for Sun State.
Jam comes to its conclusion as the hands get tapped on the hips. Waiting for the points from Fluke. There are 4 of them assigned to Sarah Gilbert and Kallio. That's a 9-point jam. Nothing scored by Sun State. Official review being called by the Kallio side, of course. This official review is sponsored by rollergirl.ca, Canada Skate Shop Experience, Canadian customer service.
And the Canadian dollar.
And the Canadian dollar.
I wish I could experience more Canadian dollars.
Sure, it'd be very nice. 64-50 on the scoreboard. All colors over the Swarm. 4 minutes and 19 seconds is where the clock stops. We are in the first half of the 9-10 game, the first game of the seeding portion of the tournament.
Yes. Clock frozen at 4:19.
Sarah Gilbert is actually tied for the lead for scoring on the Kallio side. 21 points for her and for Layla Gay. The difference being that Layla Gay is actually at a -1 differential, which means her opponents have scored 22 points while she's been scoring the 21. Sarah Gilbert, on the other hand, has a positive differential of 11. So she's been making up a good chunk of that bonus that Kallio has, 14-point lead, and 11 of those due to Sarah Gilbert.
And looking at the penalty side of things, a very clean game, Captain Lou.
It is a very clean game. No one else other than Dumi behind and Sticks and Bones really in any kind of penalty trouble. Lots of people not taking a single one in this game. It's been the nature of this weekend that not a lot of teams have taken big penalty totals. Now, having said that, Sun State with 36 per game is on the higher end. 31.5 per game for Kallio. Oh, 4.5. It's strange that when I went and did all the numbers before the game, the numbers all looked pretty even. And again, you're looking at the 7 seed going against the 8 seed. You're looking at the 27th ranked team in the WFDA against the 29th ranked
team. Yeah, those numbers should all square up.
That's right. I mean, we should not be shocked that this game has rolled out pretty evenly, but it has.
And, yeah. Although with penalties, it's not always the how many but when. It's the inopportune moments.
Sure. And I think both of these teams have, especially in this game, adapted to the calling that they've received over the last couple of games. You come out here, you get the Division One playoffs, high-level refereeing, you sort of have to adapt. Slim, any information on that official review?
Yes. Kallio Rolling Rainbow, the all-colors were looking for a blocking with the head penalty against Sun State's jammer in the previous jam. They did not receive that call, will not retain the review, and there will be no change to gameplay.
Fair enough. Yeah, I mean, Kallio in their previous games this weekend have been warned about blocking with the heads from their jammer, so not surprising that they, since they have had their attention focused on it by the officials during this tournament, use their official review to ask for exactly what they've been told not to do all weekend.
Sure,
and are seeing it happen against them.
Now that their eyes have been opened, yes.
That's right. So we'll get Derby back on the way. It's going to be Picante going up against Jambi.
Oh, 1 foot in fair territory means that Jambi is able to continue skating forward and into that lead position. Picante also struggling. Great toe stop work. A follow-up hit there against Picante. Picante struck down. Now a triangle of blockers forming up right in front of Picante as she stumbled. Jambi on a scoring pass. Up against Dumi behind. Gets into the center of the circle. Things slowing down. The majority of the pack moving back into turn number one. Jambi on a scoring pass. Picante with patience also emerging from the pack.
Yeah, I mean, Picante not getting lead jammer much in this game, but still able to keep her negative differential down to a minimal amount. 4 additional points picked up by Sun State, 64 to 54, 10 points separating these teams. Did you know that in addition to helmets, S1 now makes pads for roller derby too? Make S1 part of your uniform, S1helmets.com. Still, Picante not taking a single penalty in this tournament.
And that's with a lot of dancing on the toe stops at the outside line, the potential for cutting very high, and so that's some good clean skating. Layla Gay and Trauma Junkie, jammers of the moment. Trauma Junkie taken out there. Mischief doing the work. Trauma Junkie makes a recovery. Comes out of the pack, does not gain lead. A no pass. Layla Gay stashes the star.
And picks up a high block coming out of the pack, Slim.
So lead was not to be in either case.
Layla Gay with a single jammer penalty in her 2 previous games now, picking one up in this one.
Trauma Junkie in the pack. Getting another hit from Mischief. Mischief deciding she wants to bedevil Trauma Junkie in this jam.
And Mischief, one of the high rotation blockers that Kallio has been using this weekend, doing a great job. And there's Teabag as well, Slim.
Trauma Junkie endures a bit of punishment but comes out. Trauma Junkie pointing as she turns back on the track. Not sure what that communication was. But Trauma Junkie returning. Another scoring pass. Getting into the defenses, Trauma Junkie. A little leap to get into the center of things. Layla Gay back from the penalty area. Completes a pass. Now eligible to score. So Trauma Junkie has a look. Calls that off. 4 more points on the board for Sun State.
9-0 jam for Sun State. 64-63. 1 single point separate these teams as we tick down towards the last jam of the half with a minute and 20 seconds left. WFDD and Montreal Roller Derby would like to thank these companies for their generous support of this weekend's event. Rock Tape, Yelp Montreal, X-Pain Solutions, and Family Law. And on the fast girl start line, it's going to be pretty sick. Oh, no, we're going to have an official timeout. But when we get things underway, likely it's going to be pretty sick. And someone else who's wandered off the track.
It was
not a star anymore.
It was Jambi, but Jambi, because we're in a timeout situation, returning to the bench.
A little bit of a rest situation. Fair enough. Pretty sick. 6-3-6 for her lead jammer status. Pretty sick, being pretty successful. Oh, so at the end of that jam, it looks like Trauma Junkie picked up an illegal procedure. So perhaps contact after the whistle.
No, Trauma Junkie called off the jam, but wasn't lead.
Was not lead. Oh, jammer.
That was
error.
A lead. That was
tragedy.
A leaderless jam, and Trauma
That's
Junkie
right.
called it off.
Tragedy for Sun State. So unfortunate for Sun State that the jammer ref calls off the jam, although the jammer ref never would have tried it if hips weren't tapped. Pretty sick with a power start.
Yeah, and pretty sick trying to make the most of that, moving up against a trio of blockers from Sun State. Janosaurus Rex anchoring that triangle. Three becomes two, and now she splits those two apart. Pretty Sick has lead. Trauma Junkie returning from the penalty area. Trauma Junkie's fired up. She passes that star off immediately. Jambi put on the pivot star to receive this star. That was the plan all along, I suspect.
Nice.
And Pretty Sick in the pack scoring.
Yeah, nice coaching on the part of the Sun State bench. Three additional points picked up by Pretty Sick. Going to be a 7-0 jam. Wait for the scoreboard to fix up. Oh, no, wait. They added another one. Make it 4 points. 8.
We're about to run out of time. There it is. No stoppage of the clock.
So the scoreboard reading 68-63. I believe there was a second scoring pass in there. We'll see if we get an update as we wait for the jammer refs to skate over to their scorekeepers to adjust things. But nice end to the half for Kallio. Sun State leading for the majority of this half, but Kallio eventually working their way into the superior position. It's been an interesting half. It's been an even half. There's been a little chaos as we come to its conclusion.
A little bit of chaos, but on the whole, a very disciplined effort from these squads.
That's right, and even in the midst of that chaos, you know, Sun State making sure that they have their top jammer out there with the pivot stripe on their helmet. That quick star pass limited the damage that could be done. I like what I'm seeing from both teams so far, Slim.
Yeah, it's been very entertaining, and both teams striving and keeping it clean, and we will see what transpires in the second half. Thank you for joining us on WFTDA.TV at the 2016 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs in Montreal. Welcome back to the 2016 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs live from Montreal, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and Montreal Roller Derby. I am Lightning Slim. He is Captain Lou Albamo, and
This is Catman. Catman, our lovely assistant, holding a book in his hands, and that book is Eight-Wheeled Freedom by the Derby Nerd, Dave Miller. It is a great history of the game and is available from great bookstores everywhere or online. Your choice. Make sure you pick it up. Catman, thanks so much.
Thanks, buddy. Now, getting back into this game, Captain Lou.
Yeah, I mean, halftime, 68-63, Kallio leading over Sun State. Pretty even in that game. You're looking at 2 jammer penalties aside, 13 trips to the penalty box for the team from Helsinki, 10 for the team from Browns Plain, Queensland, Australia. Blockers, there's only 2 blockers that have any kind of penalty problems. That's Doomy Behind, 4 trips for Kallio, and Sticks and Bones, 3 trips for the Swarm from Sun State. You look at the rosters of these teams, they have picked up There are skaters that have picked up a fair number of penalties over the course of the games. Janosaurus Rex has fouled out of both games for Sun State. Only 1 penalty in the first half. Super
yeah,
clean.
That is a very, very big change in direction, Captain Lear.
And SX, 7 fouls out in the first game against Detroit. 4 penalties in the second game against Boston. Again, only 1 penalty and being called in to be the pivot turn jammer multiple times in that first half.
Yeah, and she did so quite well, even putting on a burst of speed, like she was very comfortable in that jamming position.
And then over on the Kallio side, you look at Pretty Sick, 8 penalties in this tournament, 3 in the first game, 5 in the second game, 0 in the second game, putting up 20 points on the scoreboard for Kallio. Sarah Gilbert, 6 penalties in her first game, 4 penalties in her second game, picked up 1 penalty, and that was in the first jam of this game, and that's what allowed Sun State to roll out to a quick lead against Kallio. It was 10-0 in that first jam, but since then she's been flawless and has had a great game for Kallio, 5 out of 6 lead jammer statuses since that first jam, and has put up 21 points for a team. So It's the team sort of adjusting their games, getting finally, it looks like they're finally comfortable out there on the track. They're playing on the sport court. They're comfortable enough with the officiating. And now they're both teams are getting to play their games, and we're seeing what the 7th and the 8th seed, the 27th and the 29th ranked teams in WFDDA can do when they play against each other in Montreal, Quebec, Canada.
Just a few seconds before we begin the second half. Kallio sitting at 68 points, Sun State at 63. So, one full scoring pass apart.
The Swarm jammer rotation down to three skaters with Chop Chop out with that calf injury from the first game. She's fine. She just needs to do some rehab when she gets back to Australia. But Trauma Junkie with 29 points. Jambi with 28 points. Baby Rocket with 6. Over on the Kallio all-color side, pretty even on the top three jammers. Layla Gay with 21. Sarah Gilbert with 21. Pretty Sick with 20. And Picante with 6. So let's get the second half. 30 more minutes of roller derby underway. We're going to get Jambi for Sun State going up against Layla Gay for Kallio.
Jambi doing a jump before the whistle to pump herself up. Seems to have worked. Jambi, lots of jump there. Coming up for lead.
Lead jammer in 6 out of the 9 jams she's been out there for the Swarm.
Layla Gay continuing to push. A trio of blockers has her in turn number 2. A no pack as the rest of the skaters just crossing that pivot line. Layla Gay escapes, now skating free. Jambi calling it off as Layla Gay catches up.
Go ahead. Multiplayer block sending SX to the penalty box. So, of course, now she has a second penalty, as we just said such nice things about her. But that's all right. 2 points for Sun State as Slim was trying to fit in before I jumped on top of his voice. 3 points separating the teams now, 68 to 65. Kallio with a 3-point lead. 29 points remaining in this game. Sarah Gilbert's going to take the star. 2-point lead, an additional point added onto that scoreboard.
To make you look silly, Kevin Lou.
Sure.
That's what they do.
No one needs to make me look silly. I'll do that all by myself.
Sarah Gilbert, Baby Rocket, into the action. Baby Rocket striving against 3. Knocks one blocker down into the infield, but that triangle pops up again. She tries the outside route, finds it more to her liking. Baby Rocket has lead for Sun State. Gilbert has doffed the star, but is still struggling, held motionless in turn 1. Baby Rocket on a scoring pass. Direction of gameplay penalty coming to Janosaurus Rex.
Yeah, I mean, penalty heavy blocker for Sun State, straight to the penalty box.
Baby Rocket, 5 points on the board, looking for more, but she has a wall to face. And just skates around that defense of Kallio, not quite set in a in an actionable position. And Baby Rocket was able to just skate around to the outside. 5 more points. Star pass for Kallio.
That's Schlegeloff. Oh, attempted apex jump, but failing it as Mischief caught her mid-air. No additional points picked up, but still those 10 points picked up will mean that Sun State is back in the lead, 76 to 68. Ahead of Kallio by 8 points, 27 and a half minutes remaining in this game. The new Radar Halo wheel achieved world-class edging without sacrificing grip. Radar on the Fast Girl start line, Pretty Sick going up.
Trauma Junkie jamming for Sun State, Pretty Sick pushing. Pretty Sick pushing 3 blockers along with her. Imposing her will physically, moving towards the pivot line. Finally, stepping over it there. Pretty Sick, using a lot of strength to do that. Trauma Junkie, sliding between blockers. Trauma Junkie picking up lead for Sun State. Meanwhile, Pretty Sick continues to press. Taking a hit there from Janosaurus Rex is Pretty Sick, but she recovers. Trauma Junkie on a scoring pass. Comes out with the full 5.
Yeah, 3 jams in, 3 lead jammer statuses. No points on the board for Kallio so far in this half.
So Kallio passing the star to number 49, Machu Picchu. Trauma Junkie gets instructions from the bench to call that off. Does so. 3 additional points scored for Sun State.
Yeah, tumbled to the ground by KO. Left her points at the back of that pack. That got the 3 three that they needed. 8-0 in that jam. 84-68 on the scoreboard as Sun State has come out in the second half. Lion has put up 19 points, make that 20 points in this half.
If you are just joining us, Sun State in the white jerseys. Kallio in the black. Picante for Kallio. Jambi for the swarm, but it is Picante. Finds a little room inside. She is out first for lead. Jambi, oh, hip to hip. A collision there, but a quick recovery from Jambi. Picante stumbling through the apex of turns one and two. Resets and hands to hips as Jambi was coming.
Picante did pick up 2 points, though, before she had to call it off. It's one of those things that the jammer wants to get back on the track, but you see the opposing jammer coming. There's no way you're going to get any additional points. No reason even to re-enter the track. Just get the hands on the hips and call it off. 84-70 is the score. Sun State in the lead by 14 points. 25 minutes remaining in this game. S1 Pro knee pad stability, function, durability, and superior shock absorption makes the S1 Pro knee pad built for roller derby.
Layla Gay jamming for Kallio. Baby Rocket for the swarm. Layla Gay bowls over Sticks and Bones to gain lead.
That's the first lead jammer status for Layla Gay in this game, even though she's tied for scoring with Kallio.
Baby Rocket tries to catch up, but the pack moving quickly. Sun State trying to run away from Layla Gay. The all colors trying to lock down Sun State. Freeze that pack in some way for Layla Gay. She gets what she can, calls it off, and it is a single, Captain Lou.
Hard fought, hard raced, single point, but now Kallio only trailing by 13. Sun State still at 84-71 for Kallio. 24 minutes, 10 seconds remaining in this game. Wftda and Montreal Roller Derby would like to thank these companies for their generous support of this weekend's event. They include Cliff Bars, Beck Cola, Cafe Central Pole, and the aforementioned eight-wheeled Freedom. And on the Fast Girl start line, we are going to get Sarah Gilbert and Trauma Junkie.
Trauma Junkie jukes to the outside, then inside, gains lead. Trauma Junkie for Sun State. Gilbert gives chase. Pack swirling around at the apex of turns one and two. Trauma Junkie grabs the jersey of a teammate. Did she get a single point? Yes, just the one.
So again, both jammers getting out. Twice the pack has raced two jams in a row, and on both sides, either team has managed to scratch out a single point after the race. 85-71 on the scoreboard. Sun State remains in lead. 14 points separate the teams. 23 minutes remaining in this game's color Falcon plates and color Q4 boots. Check out all the colorful new goods from Adam Skates on adamskates.com on the Fast Girl start line. Pretty Sick and Jambi.
Both jammers getting into the thick of things immediately, but no lead yet declared. Pretty Sick up at the front of the pack. Jambi has been recycled to the rear. Jambi looking for a little bit of real estate. Picks up speed. Jambi has lead for the swarm.
Jambi doing a great job in this game for her team, picking up lead jammer status. 7 out of 11.
Pretty Sick still fighting near the front of the pack. Cutting the track, the penalty to Pretty Sick. Now a power jam for Jambi.
Pretty Sick had been avoiding using that toe-stop line dance that she's used in the first couple games. Sort of stayed in the middle of the track, but got too close to the edges that time, back into the penalty box now.
Jambi now scoring. Sole possessor of a star on the track.
Four points awarded to Sun State at the conclusion of that jam. 9-0 in the jam, 94-71 on the scoreboard. The Australians leading the Finns with 21 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in this game. 888 protecting Derby since day one. 888.com. Kallio still has their jammer in the penalty box. It is Pretty Sick. That means the only jammer on the track will be Baby Rocket for Sun State.
Power start for Baby Rocket. Her blockers stand off to one side, allow Baby Rocket to engage, and now comes the sweep. That leaves Baby Rocket with one to beat, but Kallio quickly reforming defenses. Nice recovery there by the Finns to get in front of Baby Rocket. But she gains lead. One extra hit there on the way back from Teabag.
Pretty sick back in the pack now, Slim.
Baby Rocket now in a scoring pass. Unsurprisingly, Sticks and Bones busting apart the defense for Baby Rocket.
Yeah, she's been an expert in that all weekend long. Love her offensive.
Yeah, she's been doing tons of offense. Baby Rocket carefully resetting. Has a look at Sticks and Bones. Can you help me out?
Star Stash did not go through. Star pass was attempted.
Yeah, pretty sick having to hang on to that star. Still doing so.
Continued blocking during an OPAC, dodge and bolt to the penalty box for failure to reform.
Pretty sick, escapes the pack, but to no avail, cannot engage with the pack before the jam is called with four additional points on the board for Sun State.
Four additional points, 98 is Sun State, 71 for Kallio. 20 minutes, 15 seconds remaining in this game. Sun State on a three jam. Lead jammer status keeping Kallio at zero. They've managed to put up 14 points over that run. First three jams of this half, Sun State gets lead, then Kallio with two of their own, and then three more for Sun State. See who gets it this time. Picante, Trauma Junkie.
Pack advantage to the all colors as Dodge and Bolt languishes in the penalty box. Picante struck down to the interior. A nice avoidance of hit by Trauma Junkie. She gets lead. Picante, however, with a recovery, scooting out of the pack. Trauma Junkie on a scoring pass, tries to move through the middle and inverts the hips, calls off the jam. She had a little more time to work with, but elected to call it off right then, gets three.
That puts them over the century mark at 101. Kallio remaining at 71, only able to put up 3 points in the second half. Sun State's defense doing a great job. Their jammer's doing a great job getting lead jammer status, really keeping Kallio off of the scoreboard. On the fast girl start line will be Sarah Gilbert. Lined up behind her is Jambi for the swarm.
Gilbert, Jambi into the pack immediately. Jambi pushing. The feet never stop moving for Jambi. And gaining lead, Jambi of Sun State.
Five lead jammer statuses in a row for Sun State, continuing to look to build their lead.
Jambi into the pack. Gilbert on the way.
One single point snagged as that wall of all colors at the back of the pack held solid. Only one hip passed, and now Sun State's at 102. Kallio remains at 71. They have been static at 71 for the last five jams.
Jambi managed to call that jam off with just one hand on hip.
Biggest lead of the game at the moment, 31 points for Sun State. They look to take the ninth place.
Layla Gay and Baby Rocket, jammers of the right now. Layla Gay keeps things moving forward and is rewarded with lead. Baby Rocket steps over the apex, has also escaped into the clear.
Yeah, multiplayer block to Coconuts opened that up for her.
Things at a runaway pace now. Layla Gay can't quite catch all of the Sun State skaters. Did get two.
2 points. Nice bump out at the end of that jam. Forced by Edwards. Trailing blocker. Still gave up the single. Got the one extra point. Not on the track point for Coconuts. So 2-0. Kallio's fifth point of this half as the defense from Sun State has been strong. Don't forget, if you want to interact with the announcers all day long, please use the hashtag #talk2WFTDA on the Twitters. We may or may not talk to you, but we will read your tweets afterwards. Say nice things.
Picante, Trauma Junkie. Trauma Junkie recycled. Quite a long drawback there. Picante struggling also. Tries to take the whip off of Teabag. Bodies fall. Trauma Junkie. What a knock to her knees. And that recovery. The Rockstar slide through and picks up lead. And out of that mayhem, Picante getting a high blocking penalty. Power jam for Trauma Junkie.
Yeah, Picante thought she had a line, but stumbling to the ground with Sticks and Bones, she was inverted. And Picante went straight into her face.
Getting instructions from the bench to keep working it. Trauma Junkie skates on. 5 points in the back pocket already. Looking for more. One blocker held back Sun State Goading, number 60. That's KO. Trauma Junkie comes out. That's another five. This is Sun State extending their lead, Captain Lou.
Yeah, Sun State on a real roll in the second half, putting up big points.
Sticks and Bones breaking that up. Getting some space for Trauma Junkie. Now a 15-point jam for her. Picante is back on the track, but still has to complete an initial pass. Picante pushing against Sticks and Bones. Coconuts getting in on that. A trio of blockers going to work on Picante. Picante finally finishes that initial. Trauma Junkie continues to score, calls that off.
Those additional 4 points will mean that Sun State gets 19-0 in that power jam. 121-73. 58 points scored in this half by Sun State to the five that they have given up. A 58-5 run over the last 15 minutes for Sun State.
That might be the largest jam of the game.
19 points, I think it is, actually, because we've had very low scoring jams. And a timeout's going to get called by the Sun State bench. They're going to stop the clock with 15 minutes to go, make it 14 minutes and 52 seconds. This timeout, of course, being brought to you by rollergirl.ca, Canada's skate shop. Experience the Canadian dollar.
And speaking of timeouts, Captain Lou, there are so many of them left.
There are. There's lots of clock stoppages available. We have criticized Sun State in the past for their clock use, especially in that game against Boston. However, I don't mind this clock stoppage. Your team is on a roll. Momentum's in your favor, but you just get one last little stoppage at the halfway
mark. Well, yeah, a discussion of how to hammer the coffin shut on Kallio, right? It's like, just keep working our system.
That's right. You get back there, you cheer for each other, you make sure that you go out and play the final 15 minutes, because if they play this right, they're looking like strong favorites to finish in ninth place. 5 seconds to go before the jam starts. It's going to be Sarah Gilbert for Kallio, Jambi for the Swarm.
Jambi cautiously picking away to the front, challenging the blockers of Kallio. Gilbert forcing a multiplayer blocking penalty on Janosaurus Rex by that constant pressure that Gilbert was applying to that triangle. And Gilbert now sees a little bit of room on the inside, steps over the apex, lead for Kallio.
Janosaurus Rex up to 3 trips to the penalty box now, still relatively clean for her in this tournament.
And Janosaurus Rex has been anchoring all of those defensive triangles. She's been doing a ton of work out on the track.
Yes, she has.
Skating in 21 jams. Gilbert hits the pack, calls it, picks up two.
Only the fourth lead jammer status of the half for Kallio, but they do pick up those 2 points, as you mentioned, Slim. 121-75 the score, just under 14 minutes remaining in this game. Fast Girl Skates, 9 years dedicated to making a faster you. And on the Fast Girl start line, we're going to get Baby Rocket and Layla Gay. Baby Rocket with 20 points for Sun State so far in this game. Layla Gay, 24.
Slow start to things. Oh, and just a little nudge there from Edwards puts Layla Gay out. An opportunity there for Baby Rocket. Baby Rocket coming out with lead.
Star pass to Schlagerloff.
Yeah, Schlagerloff putting on the star as she approaches the pack. Baby Rocket sees her coming a mile away. Calls that off. 2 additional points put up by Sun State.
So that matches the 2 that Kallio had in the previous jam. 123-75. Score continues to be in the Sun State favor. 13 minutes remaining in this bout. Again, you're watching WFTDA.TV, the 9-10 bout at the Division 1 playoffs in Montreal. 7 and the 8 seed competing. Sun State in the white, Kallio in the black.
Yeah, a bit of a tumble in the seeding for both of these teams, but nobody wants to come out in that 10 spot. Pretty sick pushing for Kallio. Trauma Junkie recycled, pushed around. Trauma Junkie collides with Janosaurus Rex, and another trip to the box for Janosaurus Rex. She was very clean in the first half. It has not worked out that way for her in the second.
I guess she figured she has six to give. Might as well give all she wants in the second half.
Pretty sick. With patience, comes out with lead. Now on a scoring pass, Trauma Junkie recycled again.
Bella Glucosi to the penalty box for Kallio.
5 points for Pretty Sick.
That'll put Pretty Sick in the lead for scoring for Kallio, 25 in this game.
Pretty Sick now entering the pack again on a scoring pass. The pack in turn number three. Pretty Sick sails through. Some confusion there. And Pretty Sick unperturbed coming out with the full five. Star pass, Sun State. That goes to Dodge and Bolt.
See if Pretty Sick decides to run this.
It might be advantageous to do so. Pretty Sick now enveloped by a trio of blockers and Captain Lou, Janosaurus Rex.
We should never say nice things about anybody. They'll just take a million penalties. It's fine. It was a failure to reform. It was just a no-pack situation.
Pretty Sick skating on, continuing to score. Pretty Sick with a smooth stride. It doesn't look like she's moving her feet that quickly, but it just eats up track.
It still has 15 seconds left in this jam in order to put one more scoring pass in.
Yep. Already 19 for Kallio. Quite a recovery. Pretty Sick in the pack, looking for more. And one last hit. Did she pass that last set of hips? Four.
4 points. Yeah, so a 23-4 jam. That is the biggest jam of the game.
And the crowd in Montreal gets into that.
They do indeed. Sun State 127-98 for Kallio. 10.5 minutes to go in this game. And all of a sudden, Kallio has brought them back to life with that huge jam by Pretty Sick. We've seen that all weekend long. When the jammers from Kallio can find some space, they will put big numbers up. See what Picante does against Jambi.
Yeah. Jambi quickly jumping out for lead. Picante pushing, now finding a bit of space. Oh, great work by Picante to stay inside the track boundary. Now Picante skating free. Jambi kills a few seconds off the clock, calls it off.
Jambi killing a bit of the momentum Kallio had built as well. 131-98 is the score on that 4-0 jam. 9 minutes and 45 seconds. Yeah, you're talking about Picante and staying strong in the track. She used every inch of that apex. She made sure that every hit she took, she was still had a tiny bit more room to reset and make her way out of the pack. Only allow one scoring pass for Sun State. But Sun State remains in the lead by 32 points on the fast girl start line. Sarah Gilbert going up against Baby Rocket.
Gilbert with strength on the inside line coming out for lead. Baby Rocket also battling, also able to use every inch of apex space, but not quite cutting the track. The penalty to Baby Rocket, but also the penalty to Gilbert. We have a double jammer sit down.
So we'll get ourselves a jammer swap out. We'll go with a full 2 minutes, but advantage is still in Kallio's favor.
I think Baby Rocket and Gilbert both agreed that life was unfair. They had a momentary conversation in the penalty area.
Well, it was number 7 and number 777. You always wonder if there's a little bit of confusion on there.
So lead no longer available. These jammers will have to work. 1 minute 12 left in the jam.
Coach Dad on Twitter once again echoing our thoughts. Meanwhile, this boat refuses to become boring.
And thank goodness.
We're all about non-boring derby.
That's right. Gilbert now inside. A little hop, grabs the toe stops. Now head-to-head against Sticks and Bones. And a follow-up hit there from Veruca Salt. But Gilbert will not be denied. 4 more points.
Star pass being attempted. Now it's a star stash, but it is a scoring pass.
Oh, Baby Rocket upended. Ouch. But maintains vertical integrity, gets back up again. Gilbert skates on. Both jammers now neck and neck coming into turn number three. Baby Rocket throws a hit on Gilbert, but unable to disturb her.
Size disparity. Matthew Beachu picked up that low block that baby rocket tripped on.
Gilbert demands offense from her blockers, and they comply, creating a bit of space for Gilbert.
She's been out there for 110 seconds at that point in the jam. She was tired. I don't blame her. She did pick up five more points. We get an official review being requested. 13-4 in that jam. Kallio at 111, 135 for Sun State. Official review taken by Kallio, and of course, official reviews are brought to you by Fast Girls. No, that's not Fast Girls. Hey, sorry, Roller Girl, rollergirl.ca. This timeout sponsored by you, Canada Skate Shop. Experience.
So,
Canadian customer service.
These swings in momentum have brought the hardy souls who've come here to watch the first game of the morning, brought them back to life. Interesting things happening on the track. We'll get you the details of the official review whenever we can. Kallio 111, Sun State 135, 7:19 on the clock. Captain Lou, Kallio, if they want to get back into this, is 7 minutes enough? Do they have enough runway?
They've got plenty of time. They only have 24 points to give. They've put up 24 points or 23 points in the previous jam. It was a 19-point bonus. But you're looking at, you know, two jams. They can bridge this gap if they have the right jammers out there and the blockers continue to remain strong. The jammer matchups that they're getting against Baby Rocket are the ones that are really working for them. Nothing against Baby Rocket. She's put 26 points up in this game, but the defense has been able to slow her down a bit more than the other two. Jambi and Trauma Junkie have 45 points and 64 points for the Swarm. And Baby Rock is at a negative 26 differential. So that's something you have to wonder if maybe on the Sun State bench you're down into the 7 minutes. When you get down maybe one more rotation on Baby Rocket, we might want to look at going 1-2 with Jambi and Trauma Junkie. So they're getting good lead jammer percentage. But Kallio refuses to die in this game. We're happy that you have joined us for the morning game of WFTDA.TV.
That's right, you're watching the 2016 International WFTDA Division I playoffs.
I mean, if you missed the morning game yesterday, you missed a heck of a barn burner as well.
So
These games are well worth waking up early, or as in the case of the Finns, staying up to a reasonable evening hour.
Or for the Aussies, it might be the middle of the night.
That's right. I hope you don't have to go to work too early, because you're probably up a touch late, or at least a touch late for me. At my accelerated age. So yeah, we're still waiting for this official review. Official review, of course, taken by Kallio. It is their first time stoppage of this half. They do have three more chances to stop the clock. So we'll be looking to see what they can do with the remaining 7 minutes and 19 seconds in this game. Lots of opportunity to control the clock. Lightning Slim, do you have any information at all about that official review?
I do, Captain Luke. Kallio had requested a penalty box violation against the opposing jammer in the preceding jam. It was not awarded, so the no call will stand. Loss of official review and no change to gameplay.
Fair enough. So official review is gone, but three more stoppages for Kallio if they want them. It's going to be Layla Gay going up against Jambi.
Jambi, a big hit there, but it does not deter Jambi from skating on.
The Valhalla attempting to send her to the Rainbow Bridge with that hit.
That's right. Jambi scoring pass. The full five there. Layla Gay, knocked to the exterior, star pass, Kallio. Machu Picchu receiving the star, but has to contend with the blockers of Sun State. One to beat at the front, a no pack. Now she escapes, but never mind. The jam called with three more points on the board for Sun State.
Sun State 143, Kallio 112, 8-0 in that jam. I like the fact that the Sun State blockers did not pursue. They had lead jammer status. They could call off the jam whenever they wanted to. Even though Machu Picchu was the pivot turn jammer, sometimes it's not worth it to take that extra step, possibly get the out of play block, possibly reach and get that forearm. You've got control of the jam already. It's okay for it to get called off. A little more time ticks off the clock. 6 minutes remaining in this game.
Picante and Trauma Junkie applying themselves to the Fast Girl start line. And now the pushing game. Things off to a slow start. The pack inside the starting area has not crossed the pivot line. Trauma Junkie breaks off one blocker. We've seen her do this before, but this time with a forearm, that is the determination of the jammer referee, forearm penalty to Trauma Junkie. Power jam for Picante. Picante just has to make it through the pack with the speed and the footwork. Picante has lead.
So now we see what Kallio can do. Picante only 8 points in this game, but an opportunity to bring her team within striking distance in the dying moments. And picks up a track cut.
That is not good. Picante going to the penalty area.
So even worse for Kallio, that means this jam's going to run the full 2 minutes, both jammers on the track.
Trauma Junkie returning. Pack at a standstill in the back straightaway. Blockers standing to one side for Trauma Junkie. Waiting for her to get into the pack. They were about to sweep for Trauma Junkie, but another penalty this time. Low blocking. Trauma Junkie will take another seat. Second penalty of the jam for Trauma Junkie of Sun State.
No swap out available in this one. Time has to expire on Picante's first penalty as it was attached to the first penalty Trauma Junkie got.
Picante now back on the track. Only jammer on the track. Gets around. Genosaurus Rex Picante continues to skate. That is a 5-point pass. An opportunity here for Kallio.
You have to wonder if fatigue's becoming a factor as there have been 5 jammer penalties in the last 3 jams.
Low block penalty assessed here against the All Colors. Picante pushing. Tries to get around Sticks and Bones as the jam times out. 4 more points on the board.
Yeah, that was Cutty Schrodinger who picked up that low block. 4 more points, as Slim said, 9-0 in a jam for Kallio. 121 to 143, 22 points separating these teams as Sun State holds on to their lead with 3 minutes and 45 seconds left. The Wftda would like to thank Spank Alley, Chaya, Cone Law Offices, and 888. Fast Girl Startline has pretty sick going against Jambi.
Jambi cruising up the inside line, now tries the outside, trying to use lateral movement to fool that triangle of blockers. Did her skates go out of bounds? Yes, she determined, certainly so. Jambi having to recycle. Valhalla holding the inside line, but Jambi barges past into lead.
Jambi's basically going every second jam now, Slim.
Pretty sick, skating free, putting pressure on Jambi. Hit and quit from Jambi.
All right,
and just a single.
Just a single, but more importantly, time continues to tick down in this game. Kallio does have 3 clock stoppages. They are under 3 minutes to go. They really ought to use one of them in order to get this clock stopped, but time continues to tick down in this game. 1 minute, 44 seconds left, or 1 minute and 44, let's not talk about minutes, let's talk about points. 145 points, another additional point added to Sun State. 121 for Kallio, 24 points separate to team Sarah Gilbert, Baby Rocket.
Yeah, Kallio's bench was requesting a back block there from the bench. Didn't work, and time ticked away the whole time. Right. Gilbert with lead.
They should have just called a timeout and then requested it.
Gilbert. A powerful jam, puts up 5.
KO's helmet hitting Sticks and Bones.
Janosaurus Rex now receiving a 6th penalty. High block, the penalty there. Baby Rocket into the pack. Gilbert skates on. Now 9 points on the jam, looking for more.
It's getting close. There's another one, Slim.
The crowd responding to the points getting closer together, these scores. Baby Rocket also scoring 4 points on the board for Baby Rocket. Gilbert coming through. Gilbert also has 4.
Matching points not going to help Kallio, though. Time under 90 seconds remaining in this game.
Machu Picchu takes out Baby Rocket. Bench. Baby Rocket, however, manages to escape the pack now, sort of ahead in the scoring race.
The bench is exhorting their teams to keep going.
5 on that pass for Gilbert. We may run out of time soon, Captain Lou.
There's 55 seconds left in this game.
Yeah. Still, stoppages available to Kallio, 3 of them. I don't think you can chop 40 seconds into 3 pieces.
You cannot.
Gilbert skates on.
Gonna calls it off. And Kallio really needs to use a timeout here. They really do. You've got three clock stoppages. You're down by 7 points. It's 155 to 148. Yes, you just put up a 27 to 10 jam, but you have the opportunity to stop the clock if you want. WFTDA would like to thank Moda Skates, Rowline, Bruce Skate, Noose, Double Threat Skates, Fast Girl Skates, and RollerGirl.ca, and of course, 515 Magazine.
Kallio using all of the lead-up time.
Yeah.
Every last second before calling that timeout.
That's not the way I would do it, but that's the way they chose to do it, and that's up to them. So yeah, 14 seconds is where the clock stops. This is going to be the last jam. Kallio rolling all of their dice on the last jam.
So that last jam shook out at 27-10 in favor of the All Colors.
Team timeout, of course, sponsored by RollerGirl.ca, Canada Skate Shop, Experience Canadian Customer Service. And WFTDA and Montreal Roller Derby would like to thank these companies for their generous support of this weekend's event. They include Neon Skates, Nerd Skates, Team Canada, Texas Roller Girls, RollerSkating.ca, Studio La Gazelle, Midnight Matinee, La Boite Therapeutique, and Bose Brewery. So yeah, I mean, 14, here we go.
14 seconds of official game time remaining. Enough to get a jam started.
Enough to get a jam started. Now the question is, do you want Sarah Gilbert out there? You have two more timeouts. If you do, you could rest her, and you could put her out there. You're going to go with Pretty Sick. Yes, it looks like a second timeout is going to be used by the Kallio bench. As they say thank you to Drop Dead Gorgon, the jam timer.
So yeah, the Finns stacking up the timeouts, getting a bit of rest to their bench, but rest for one is rest for another, Captain Lou.
It is, but regardless, you know, Kallio has had decent success getting lead jammer status. Not in this half. They have a tough time in this half, only 7 times out of the 21 jams that have been played. But that big jam by Sarah Gilbert, bringing them to within striking distance. Pretty Sick also having another big jam in this half. And yeah, I mean, you're risking it all, and they're gonna throw Gilbert out there again. Now you got one more timeout in the bank. Quite honestly, I hope they burn this last timeout as well, because you're not keeping it into overtime. If you can get it to overtime, you're not keeping it once time's expired on the clock. And if you've burned two, you might as well burn three to give her one more minute to rest. They're not gonna do it, that's fine. And Jambi going to take the star for Sun State. Wise move by Sun State, 65% lead.
Pretty good choice, certainly. Yep.
So it all comes down to the defense, really. Who can stop the top jammers from either side?
Jambi, Gilbert, all the marbles. Here we go. Jambi dancing back and forth. We've seen this technique from her before. Dancing back and forth to see if she can get the inside or the outside line available to her. Gilbert also using her preferred method of pushing. Jambi, one to be to the front of the pack. Jambi lead for Sun State.
No time on the game clock. Jambi can call it off whenever she wants. Jen Heath on the bench indicates that she needs to. She does. And Sun State's going to walk away with a victory, Slim.
Jambi falls to the track, overcome, surrounded by her teammates.
A fantastic effort by the top jammer for Sun State this weekend.
Chop Chop being chair-lifted into this victory circle.
She'll enter the camera now, yes.
There she is.
Calf muscle tear, keeping her out of the majority of this tournament. Occurred versus Detroit by getting to be part of the group hug at the end of this game. The score becomes an official final with a rolling whistle. 155 for the Sun State Swarm as they defeat the Kallio All Colors, Kallio Rolling Rainbow. 155 to 148 scoring in this game. Trauma Junkie, top scorer for the Swarm, 64 points. Jambi with 55 points, but lead jammer status of 71%. And Baby Rocket with 36 over on Kallio. Sarah Gilbert with 64 points. Pretty Sick with 43. Layla Gay with 24. And 17 for Picante. Janosaurus Rex did not have enough time to foul out of this game.
She certainly put the effort in on the track.
I like those skaters that play on the edge.
Absolutely.
I really do.
Oh, no slouch at holding down that defensive triangle was Janosaurus Rex.
You wind them up, put them on the track, and let them do their thing. That's what she did in that second half. Only one penalty in the first half, 5 in the second half. Game relatively clean on both sides. 6 jammer penalties for Kallio, 5 jammer penalties for the Swarm.
And that's how we start out placement day on day 3 of the Division 1 playoffs here in Montreal. So Kallio will take 10th Sun State ninth.
Yeah.
And
it was a heck of a good game. I mean, Kallio had the lead for a short bit of time in that game, and Sun State came right back. Sun State really dominant in the first part of that second half, running up a huge differential, and that's what allowed them to ride out this game to victory. Looking back on this game, hopefully Sun State and especially Kallio will look at the essence of time management.
After a very disciplined first half in which the two teams were basically both just running their program against each other, yeah. And then in the second half there was some penalty problems, and that makes the game more technical, and it puts more onus on the coach to do more.
And Sun State trailing in that game likely could have had one or two more jams if they'd used their timeouts in a more organized manner, but they did what they did, and they still gave themselves a good chance. So Slim, I mean, just a great first game for the third day.
All right, thanks for joining us here. I'm Lightning Slim with Captain Lou. We're throwing it down trackside with Wilhelm Scream. He has Jambi, Trauma Junkie, and Essex with him. Take it away, Wilhelm.
Thank you, Lightning Slim and Captain Lou. As mentioned, I'm here with a couple of members of the Sun State Swarm. Actually, first question, SX. You call your team the Swarm, and watching your defense is pretty obvious to see why. Your team kind of cycles through. You don't have a dedicated offensive blocker. Why is that part of the strategy?
Because... We're all training in all aspects of roller derby. I mean, we've got our set jammers, but we have pivots that can jam. We have defensive blockers that can offense. Funnily enough, I actually am the worst offensive skater on the team. We try and avoid me helping as often as possible.
She makes up for it with her defense.
Yeah, yeah.
And this one, Trauma, you were the top scorer for your team in that game, pulling in 64 points. During the first half, it seemed like you guys were having a lot of difficulty with Kallio's size and physicality. What was the adjustment you made in the halftime?
Our jammers are quite interesting. We're all so different. Yeah. But we've all been working on our juking game. And I think we recognized early on that ain't going to work with this team. They're so agile, but they're so big as well. So we really focus on our 45 degree angle drives. Patience, and then waiting for a quick juke once they'd really committed, but it took a lot of adjusting. They were so hard to get past. I would say they were the hardest defense we came up against this weekend, but I think all of our jammers adjusted well.
Yeah. And speaking of this weekend, overall, none of the games were easy. They were all nail biters. Came down to the final jam again, but you guys came out of nowhere last year to enter in the Division One, and I think this year you really proved that you are a Division One team. How did that experience last year really help you set up for this year?
Well, yeah. So last year at the end of Div One playoffs, we actually lost 9 veteran skaters. So this year, we've come back with only 6 of the previous team that we brought here last time. So we've actually had a ridiculously tough rebuilding year. So to win that game for us was just
huge,
which is why we all fell down in tears, because we've worked so hard. You know, we have had a couple of losses this year and a couple of great wins, and we've done, you know, we grabbed our mates VRDL and got them to help us tighten up our things. Thanks, Victoria.
Yeah, and people like Scald and Mani offered us a lot of advice, and we really appreciate it. Thank you.
So we've taken, you know, that high-end advice. You know, and as we're sitting here, you know, the Victoria girls are giving us little bits of advice as we go. You know, they're our mates and they help us out. And, we've just sort of changed everything. We changed our play. We went to offensive play rather than just D, which you probably couldn't tell in that game because we've really stuck back to D. But, we learned to be patient and understand that it's growth, and we're never going to be in the top 10 unless we work there. You don't just get there.
I think one of the biggest things to our success this year was we genuinely fell more and more in love with each other with every week that we train together. It just feels so tight and together and like we're sisters.
Well, excellent. Go and celebrate with your sisters. Congratulations on taking 9th place here in Montreal. Stay tuned. You're going to be watching WFTDA.TV. The 7th place game is coming up next, featuring Rocky Mountain and Detroit.